Hello children and welcome to the class, EVS class. I hope you are all fit and fine and taking good care of yourself. So children, what is today's date? Today's date is 23rd of June 2020. And children, we have finished our three chapters of EVS and we are currently doing lesson number 4. And you remember what is the name of lesson number 4? Yes, children, it's things around us, and we have already started this lesson. So children, let's do a quick recap of what we have studied till now. So children, all of you take out your textbook and turn to lesson number 4, that is things around us, so that when I'll be explaining, you just go through the book and it will be more easy for you to understand. So children, take out your textbook and turn to lesson number 4. Let's do a quick recap of what we have studied. We have studied things around us, the name of the lesson. And here, what did we study? We study mainly about two very important things, that is living things and non-living things. So what are living things? Here it's given. Living things breathe, they breathe, okay? They need food and water to live. Living things grow from small to big. Then living things can move, okay, they can walk, run and jump. Plants are also living things, and living things give birth to young ones, they give birth to children, okay. And what are the living things? The living things are children, human beings, men, animals, birds, and plants are the living things. Now we come to the non-living things. What are non-living things? Non-living things, you can see here, children, there's a picture, it's given. Table, then a bag is there, a ball is there, a fan is there, and a pair of shoes are there. So these are all non-living things. And what does non-living things do? They don't breathe, okay? And they don't need food and water to live because they don't eat. Then they don't grow from small to big. Whatever their size is, they remain the same only. They cannot move from one place to another, and they don't give birth to children. Okay. Does ever a table give birth to children? No. Does a table move by itself? No. Does a table or a ball breed? No. Does a table grow from a small to big, or whatever the size it is, does it grow more bigger? No. So these are all non-living things. So children, in the next page you can see there is an exercise and it's given there. Look at the pictures given below and tick mark the living things across. So you'll have to tick mark the living things. So which are the living things, children? The living things are apple, tree, then children, a bird. Okay, these trees are living things because they breathe and they grow, okay? And there is also an astronaut, and this is also a living thing. Then children, we come to a very important thing, that is we have studied things are of two types, that is living and non-living things. Now we'll study about two more important types of living things, that is natural things and man-made or artificial things. So what are natural or man-made things? We'll study. Here it's given, children. Living things that are made by human beings are called man-made things or artificial things, okay? So things which are made by man are called man-made things. Like children, here example is given, doll, teddy, ball, skateboard, chair, etc. These are all made by man, they are artificial, okay? So these are man-made or artificial things. And what are natural things? Things which we get in nature. Okay, children, like here it's given cloud, stone, storm, then moon, wind, mountain, etc. These we all get in nature. Okay, they cannot be made by men, or they are not made by men. So these are natural things. So children, with this we come to the end of the lesson. Okay, and in things around us, we have studied about four important things: living things, non-living things, and today we have studied about natural things and artificial or man-made things. So what are natural things? Things which are in nature, which are not made by man. There are so many things like clouds, stones, storm, moon, wind, mountain, plants, trees, animals, birds, then children, water, then snow, sunlight, etc. And artificial and man-made things are also many: doll, teddy, ball, skateboard, chair, table, sofa, pencil box, earrings, clothes, etc. These are artificial, or these are made by men. Okay children, so let's proceed with the next topic. What do we have? English fun. This is your homework, and you'll have to do this on your own. Yes, you can see here, this is English fun, and it's given here. You'll have to write three words related to each of the following, like living things and non-living things. Three words related to living things and three words related to non-living things. Okay, so this will be your homework. Then we come, since we have come to the end of the chapter, children, we'll go with the workbook discussion. Okay, since we finish the chapter, we'll do workbook discussion. So all of you take out your workbook. I'll be discussing the question answers, and after the video, I'll be uploading the answer. So what is the question? Question number one, multiple choice question. I am a thing. You wear me on your foot. What am I? Very easy. What do you wear? You wear shoes. So answer will be D. Then we have number two. I am a non-living thing. You use me to write and draw. Who am I? So what do we use to write and draw? And it's a non-living thing also. It's number C, pencil. Then fill in the blanks. Number C is given. This is a, yes, O and K is given. B and O is not there, so it will be, this is a book. Then number 4, a dash is a living thing. A picture is given. Which is the living thing? A fish. So you write the F-I-S-H. F-I-H is given, you'll have to write S. So number 5, name the living thing shown in the picture. So which is the living thing shown in the picture? B-I-H. A dash is given and D is there. What will be the answer, children? It's bird. Okay, B-I-R-D. Then number 6. Neelam found these things on the way to school. Help her write their names. So it will be stone and tree. Then short answer question. Circle the non-living things given below. So which are the non-living things? You'll have to circle it. Yes, it's the pencil and the table. Others all are living things. Then we come to the next. Write yes or no. Living things can move? Yes. Living things do not move? Do not grow? No. Living things grow. Non-living things eat and drink? No. Living things give birth to young ones? Yes. Then we come to short answer questions. What do the following pictures say about living things? You'll have to fill in the blanks. First, living things move. No. Then second, living things grow. Then last, number 13, if we come, look at the picture, complete the sentence. They do not need food, F-O-O-D. And number B, they do not grow, G-R-O-W. Then we have children, number 14, multiple choice questions, and it's given. Choose the living things from the following. What is the living thing? Yes, number B, which one? Number B is the living thing because it's a bird. Then children, we come to number 15. Choose the non-living things from the following. And you'll have to choose the non-living thing. Which is the non-living thing? It's number A. Okay children, it's a toy. Then we come to number 16. Help Ayesha to rearrange the letters to get the name of a living thing. The letters are jumbled up, and what is, if you write it in the correct way, what is the answer you'll get? The answer is of an elephant, E-L-E-P-H-A-N-T. Then number 17, name the non-living thing in the given picture. It's a chair. Yes children, it's a chair, C-H-A-I-R, chair. And lastly, question number 18, it's given, a robot is a machine that walks and talks. Is robot a living thing? Write yes or no. No, robot is not a living thing. Write yes or no for the following questions. You'll have to write, can it breathe? No. Can it eat food and drink water? No. Can it grow? No. Can it move? Yes. Can it give birth to young ones? No. So children, with this we come to the end of the lesson. We have finished our 4 chapters and this was our last chapter. So children, after the video I'll upload the answers in the file and you'll all write it down in your workbook in a very neat way. I'll be also giving you the homework and you will submit it to me. Okay, I'll give you the date. So children, take care of yourself and have a good day. Okay children, bye bye.